Denver, a suspected cartel gunman seen walking across the Texas border, holding rifles and wearing body armor. The House Homeland Security Committee says that they will investigate how Mexican cartels are taking advantage of the Customs and Border Patrol One app, the CBP app. Chairman Mark Green putting out this statement, quote, President Biden and Secretary Mayorkas have provided cartel organizations more innovative ways to evade our laws, rake in money from human and drug trafficking, and wreak havoc in our country. Joining me right now is the man himself, Tennessee Congressman, Chairman of the House Homeland Security Committee, Mark Green. Mr. Chairman, thanks very much for joining us this morning.
Thanks, Maria.
So what do you make of these pictures, and what can you tell us in terms of what you know that the cartels are taking home? How much money are they making on this human trafficking and drug trafficking? They are the ones who are deciding who comes into America, the drug cartels.
Yeah, absolutely. No one goes across our southern border without approval and a remittance to the drug cartels. And in the case of, like, Chinese nationals, it's $50,000 a person. They're making around $13 to $14 billion a year just on human trafficking alone. And we told them, we warned them, that the CBP One app will be basically used by the cartels. And sure enough, Washington Examiner broke the story, I think it was a week ago, that they've set up a specific VPN and are filling out the applications for people to speed them into our country. It's absolutely absurd.
So former President Trump is calling out President Biden for refusing to take on China. Watch this.
How can you be tough in China when they're paying you a lot of money? We have a compromise. We have a Manchurian candidate. They know too much. So he can't be tough in China. That's why he allows blimps flying over the country, right over our nuclear sites.
So we want to know more about this. New reports show President Biden is expected to issue an executive order sometime this week, which would curb U.S. investments in Chinese tech sectors, Congressman. But we've been waiting on this executive order now for months. And we've seen the weak response that Joe Biden has given China, despite, a surveillance balloon, police stations in America, massive cyber activity, hacking the State Department and the Commerce Department. And there's, like, no response. He just keeps sending cabinet members to China. Why?
Yeah, it's pretty crazy when you think of it, if you just add it up. I mean, and one of the things that's probably the most concerning to me was the hack on our transmission cables to Guam, our military forces that are in Guam. China hacked that. Why we haven't done this months ago, and Josh Hawley and I had a bill that we introduced 3 or 4 years ago about licensing.
Join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MCAD TV family. Please like and share MCAD TV. We love you all. Please support MCAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.